No, it doesn't mean physically. We can see that they know the devil physically. You know
No, no,
that,
no, no,
right?
no, no. You know, Muhammad, he saw a woman. She made him horny, but she did nothing wrong. She just walked in the front of the house. If Muhammad was a decent man, how a woman she made him horny? Why a Muhammad?
Okay.
How
I don't know anything. I'll be honest. I don't know anything about this subject.
Can we change the subject to the depression? You know. Come on, you are a Muslim.
You know, you don't want to answer the depression one. You know.
I'm having a conversation with you. This is what the
Allah promised you depression. Allah promised you depression, and you know it's gonna hit you. And you know you have it right now. Wallahi. That's why you're here talking about Allah.
The only depression I have is talking to Muslims because they are so silly and so stupid. This is the only
He just told you he has depression. Wallahi,
hold on. Let me ask you. So when Muhammad had depression, is that because he was suffering like somebody else? Because Muhammad.
No, we're not talking about depression because you're getting persecuted. The Prophet was. People were teasing him in his homeland. This is different.
Read with me. It says that the guy who was making the Quran for him, Waraqa ibn Naufal, he passed away. And then the divine inspiration also paused. So the guy, he died, no more Quran. Obviously, it's clear. For a while, and the Prophet became so sad, as we have heard, that he intended several times to throw himself from the top of the high mountains. And every time he went to the top of the mountain in order to throw himself, Jibreel would appear in front of him and hold him from his panties and say to him, "Oh, Muhammad, indeed you are messenger of Allah." Whereupon in his heart became quiet and he would come down and he would return home. And whenever the period...
That's just proof that the Prophet is Allah's messenger because the angel Jibreel saved him.
No, my friend, this is the proof that your Prophet had mental illness.
I know you don't believe in Gabriel.
We believe in Gabriel, not Jibreel. Which Jibreel?
No, you believe an angel became the devil.
No, listen, Abdul. You're a prophet here. He tried to commit suicide many times. You tell me why. Many times.
Why? Because of the reason it says, but it doesn't. I'm not talking about that.
Allah says to you. Tell me what is the reason. I want you to read the reason for me. What is the reason? Tell me the reason.
You are indeed Allah's messenger in the truth.
Thank you very much. So Muhammad himself do not believe he is Allah's messenger, correct?
At the time that the thing was happening to him?
Thank you very much. So why I will believe in him? Take care. If Muhammad himself don't believe he is Allah's messenger, why in the world any donkey in the world want to believe that he is a messenger? If the messenger do not believe he is a messenger, to the point he tried many times to commit suicide. Imagine I want to commit my suicide. I say to you, I'm not a messenger. I want to die. I want to kill myself. And then you believe in me as a messenger? You must be stupid. I am the messenger saying to you, I am not a messenger. I want to kill myself. I don't believe I am a messenger. And then he sees somebody coming to him, and supposedly this is Jibreel. And look, Jibreel don't come to him when he want to leave the house. He wait until he climbed the mountain. I mean, don't you see? Why you didn't come to him? Like, Allah do not know, do not read the mind of this poor guy. Come to him before he go to the mountain. I mean, why you went him all the way to the mountain and he want to jump and now you hold him?